All right, is everybody ready? Our featured performance of the evening. Everyone, Josh Rose.
Grab the water, but it touched my open hand, fell off my fingers and onto the wasteland. Tried to grab the lifeline, but the cord was short and frayed. The last ones of the dinosaurs. I'm the last one of the last ones. The last ones of the dinosaurs. They built the world around us. Now it's all so spreading out. A monster that slowly consumes itself. For a while I walked the shoreline and tried to make a decent sword. In the canyon of steel wire and keyboards. The last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. I'm the last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. The comet's in the skyline, at least it's what I think it is. No one really seems to notice it. You can call me what you like, you can call me ignorant, but don't take my life and tell me how to live it. The last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. And the last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. Now I know what happened to the river. It only flows cause it's got no voice, got no say. Why do we always have to follow nature? Be the last shot, last drop, the last dot that finally floats away. I'm the last one of the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. I'm the last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. I'm the last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. I'm the last one, the last ones, the last ones of the dinosaurs. Thank you. that was a song about getting older, you know? And sometimes I feel like that dinosaur that 65 million years ago saw a comet heading towards him in the Yucatan Peninsula. And this song's a little more modern. Tried to fall asleep last night at a decent hour, but it didn't take till I pictured you in the moonlit night we share. And I recall the water being still, the wind was still, the earth and your breath was still. But our beating hearts, they thumped with minds of their own. They say to strive towards some goal, 'cause the future's coming on so fast. We were naysayers in that moment, dear. We tested out long. It would last. Last offering we saw from Hollywood was some hyped up show. It instructed us of how love was supposed to go by making it some big power play. And as the credits rolled, I told you, my love, it's not some silly game. Then you smiled at me and we talked late into the night. They say to strive towards some goals, 'cause the future's coming on so fast. We were naysayers in that moment, yeah. We tested out alone. It would last. Oh, da 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 da. We attended a wedding last week, big old dance stage. No matter what single was played, people just stood around and refused to move. So later we drove back to that startup house that we're still living in. We put on those old albums that we loved and we danced there in the dark. They say to strive towards some goals, 'cause the future's always coming on fast. We were naysayers in that moment, yeah. We tested how long it would last. Whoa. Whoa.
Cheers to y'all. Thank you.
I've always loved this town of Kalamazoo. I used to play here when it was called the Craft Brow. If you guys remember the Craft Brow. And I've been doing singer-songwriter stuff for about 14 years now. I started 2004. And I hope you guys like my songs. This is what I do. This is what I love doing. And I hope music isn't dead. Guys up to Grand Rapids, and in Grand Rapids we got a couple cool covered bridges, and I'm one of those guys that actually reads those green historical markers. You'll see me with black socks pulled up and deck shoes, stopped on the side of the road, and I'll be reading those things. The one I like to go to is the one in Ada. It's this little town just east of Grand Rapids. And outside, there's this green historical marker that says that back in the days before the Thornapple River was dammed, there were times of flood on the Thornapple River. And what happened is all the townspeople would drive their wagons on top of the bridge to keep it from floating away. Like that idea, so I made a song about it. It's called Anchor. Darker than the inside of a coffin, roof is rattling like a big old drum, and I'm outstanding in the fury, watching both hell and high water come. Don't know how long it's been raining, don't know when it'll turn to gray, but this here bridge, I know it needs an anchor, or else it'll off and float away. Find some wagons with some ballast, everyone with a pair of hands, team of horses, covered lanterns, drive them on the floorboards. Don't know how long it's been raining, don't know when it'll turn to gray, sea bridge, I know it needs an anchor, or else it'll off and float away. It's the watching and the waiting to see if our plan will hold. Can't do much else. Find some shelter. Everyone's silent, soaked, and all cold. Don't know how long it's been raining. Don't know when it'll turn to gray. But this here bridge, I know it needs an anchor, or else it'll off and float. Back to the edge of my dripping hat brim, to my acreage, to my village, to my wife, my hearth, my kin. they're my foundation. When the rains come, when the wildest rivers flow, hopefully I'll keep them anchored, each to each, a tethered stone. Don't know how long it's been raining, don't know when it'll turn gray, but don't we all need ourselves an anchor, or else we'll all off and float away. A song about a bridge that really isn't about a bridge. Thanks for having me, Caitlin. Caitlin, you freaking rock, dude. I mean, so yeah, my first memory of Kalamazoo. I have a couple memories of Kalamazoo, but I came here in like 1998, and at that time I was really into like singer-songwriter stuff, and I got hooked up with this guy named Bruce Colburn. I didn't meet him personally, but he played at the State Theater, and my wife had never been to a concert, so I took her down here. She wasn't my wife, she's my girlfriend back then. And we drove down the business spur there to get into town. And we didn't know where we were going. It's the first time we'd ever been to Kalamazoo and trying to find the State Theater. And there was a guy on a bicycle riding his bike down the business spur there, and he had this much butt crack sticking out of his pants. And like literally his pants were basically down, and it really scared my wife. So she didn't want to go to the concert. But I made her persevere, and we went and saw Bruce Colburn at the State Theater. It was awesome. So one of the things I like to do when I'm a songwriter is I like to retell tales, because that's the deal. Like Paul Simon a long time ago, he said, it's the same song, it's just the way you tell it. And, I think that's pretty good advice coming from one of the greats. This is Martin D25. See if you recognize the retelling of this tale. My family, hundreds of miles away, my safety net falls neatly on my bed of pins. Typical tale of blood, booze, and old resale. A broken timeline patched by all those deadly sins will keep me from seeing ghosts this Christmas Eve. Christmas Eve. Mm-hmm.
between my ears, product of a billion years. And to fix it, I've burned my supply, bootstrap fuel, and midnight fears, and paper towel pile tears. Well, the radio plays the songs of joy. Christmas Eve. Oh, keep me from seeing ghosts this Christmas Eve. Oh, Ebenezer, you old lucky fool. Your ghosts, well, they all play by the rules, and they always kept their place in line, but not in my mind. Not in my mind. Not in my mind. Not in my mind. Suck it up, you beautiful buttercup. You're far from safe here, treading on the middle ground. But my ghosts are real, they come around like a wheel, and I hope in my white linen ocean don't drown. Oh, keep me from seeing ghosts this Christmas Eve. Oh, keep me from seeing ghosts this Christmas Eve.
I grew up in the Upper Peninsula, and it was back in the 70s and 80s, and if you guys know anything about the 70s, it was like this really like super winters during the 1970s, and so like a lot of my environment was shaped by snow, and I'm not lying about that, like literally, like, you know, I remember these huge snow drifts when I was a kid, and it was just because, you know, it wasn't just because I was short, you know, it was because they were actually huge. And so I always wanted to write a winter song, and this is it. A gray-haired poet once warned me that the world would end in ice. But if it all went down on this white winter walk, it would be alright. In the long list of doomsayers, preacher, scientist, and thief, I'll take the poet over anyone, any prediction, any belief. Free, footsteps barely make a sound. The wind erases every mark. The midnight blanket all around us, silent, cold, and dark. But I see your face glowing, and I feel the bearskin heat. Like the sunset after the red sky fell low. Hypocrisy, will we be attacked? 'Cause our production rates must be slipping, and our sense of entitlement grows. To find life, to find love in the now, in this night of snow. Let's take all those fears in front of us. Let's take all those past regrets and go bury them under that 10-foot-high wind-made snowdrift. Under that 10-foot-high wind-made snowdrift. I'm gonna invite my new friend Caitlin to sing a song with me.
We'll see how this goes.
Well, I went on to Houston and I stopped in San Antonio, and I passed up the station for the bus, trying to find me something, but I wasn't sure just what. Ended up with pockets full of dust. Well, I went on to Cleveland and I ended up insane. Bought a borrowed suit and learned to dance.
I was spending money like the way it likes to ring. Oh, I ended up with pockets full of cane. Oh, my sweet Carolina, what compels me to go? Never been to Vegas, but I gambled on my life. Built a new sprint boat, I'd raise to soothe the man. Trying to find me something, but I wasn't sure just what. Ain't it funny how some things never change? Oh, my sweet Carolina, what compels me to go? Oh, my sweet disposition, may you one day carry me says just my light bulb burning out. I miss Kentucky and I miss my family. All the sweetest winds they blow, they blow across the south.
Sweet Carolina by Ryan Adams. Caitlin's my new friend. What do you think, Caitlin? Like two, three more? What are we thinking here?
Yeah.
Two, three?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do it. I'm going to sing a song for all the, so I have two young daughters. I got into the game a little late. I had my youngest when I was 40. And I'm surrounded by women. And it's awesome. And I wrote a song for them, because that's what I do as a songwriter. And so this is a song for all of our daughters. And it'd be too easy to call you my butterfly, for I know you'll have a compass home. You won't gravitate towards the lower latitudes, and your wings will, they'll stretch and soar and grow. I think I'll call you mine. I think I'll call you mine. And it'd be too easy to call you my pearl, for it was a little rough at first, but in the string of years that has since transpired, you radiate even at your worst. I think I'll call you mine. I think I'll call you mine. It'd be too easy to call you my princess, for that's already been defined by movie screen. And when you go to seek out my royal lineage, you'll find little of which I'm the king. I think I'll call you. For our daughters. It's this next song. I dig this song because it's got a little bit of everything. There's a little bit of politics, a little bit about humanity, a little bit about relationships. A little bit about of our standing in the universe and all those great things. In the name of progress and piles of dough, we took that old river and diverted. Thirst was aplenty, and the mouths were wide. Now I can take a smooth shore stone and throw it clear to the other side. Yeah, it's all
dried up. It's all dried up. It's all dried up. Deserted. It used to be olives and outstretched hands across red and blue waters in philosophical land. But now I see nothing.
That just scared the hell out of me, I'm not gonna lie. I thought a train was coming through this building, and there it is. And it's scary, and there's a lot of graffiti on it, and I thought it was gonna kill me. And there's oil in there, and it would be a huge explosion, really, if it hit this building. I'm just gonna point that out to everybody. So I think my fears were totally founded there, but that scared the shit out of me. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I literally forgot where I was in the song. Can anybody help me? I don't. Cross red and blue waters, philosophical lands. But now I see nothing but great big divide and husks of old bridges. Smoking fried. Yeah, it's all dried up. It's all dried up. It's all dried up. Deserted. Will you gather all the cloud seeds from the valley of the forgotten? Will you gather this broken ladle from the deep well? Does pile dreams. There's a tangle of touch screens between our souls. It's a conditional roadblock. It's polished and it's bold. A mumble, a murmur, an outstretched hand. We got decades of friendship struggling for air, but the herringbone gold band from the well-lighted cave. You knew it didn't cost that much. You still slid it into place. Some primitive impulse has kept it held there. The size of my heart, not the size of the rock, was your foremost care. Dried up. No, it can't be dried up. It can't be dried up. Deserted. scared the shit out of me. So I came from a big track and field school, and when I was a freshman, I wasn't mature yet, and I was kind of gangly, and I really couldn't fit in the sports teams. Their school was big with sports, because I wasn't, you know, like totally mature yet. So what I did is I went out for track, and our coach said, hey, Rose, go over there and run the hurdles. And it was the 300 hurdles. And I went and I tried to do it, and I literally, like, found new ways to injure myself every day on those 300 hurdles. It was, like, the hardest thing. I hurt, like, so many body parts doing the 300 hurdles. So I tried them, and I sucked. And then eventually he said, hey, Rose, go over there and try the 3200. So I went and ran long distance, and I turned out to be pretty decent. So it was pretty cool. And so I'll never forget those hurdles. So this song's about the hurdles.
Unmapped and unpaved, but there may be a
Thanks, everybody. My name is Josh Rose. Thanks for coming out tonight. And I have some CDs for sale. Been doing this 14 years now. Thanks, Caitlin, for having me. Appreciate it. Kalamazoo Suite. This is a cool joint. Thanks.